Hey guys, Joe here from Xbox Games, and check it out, we got the Nerf Elite 2.0, the Turbine otherwise known as the CS-18. Now, if you guys have been following along, we've been doing a review on this complete, you know, Nerf Elite 2.0 series as the blasters come out, so check out some of them right here, some of them good, some of them bad, some of them more like, alright. Now, what's crazy is probably like 90% of you guys who watch these videos aren't even subscribed, so, like, take the 2 seconds, subscribe, get in on some of the giveaways we're doing, and... yeah, like take 2 seconds. Anyways, let's hop right into this. We were lucky to pick this particular blaster up from our local Walmart. We were actually just walking through the aisle, and someone was restocking the shelves, and they put 3 of these on the shelves, which I thought was awesome. I actually went there to get some food, right, as well as to see if they had a couple new blasters out, and they didn't have the there was one, I forgot the one I was particularly looking for. They didn't have it, so I was like, But I saw them put this, I was like, oh, I got to pick this up because this is going to be gone in probably an hour because they only put 3 out. Now, the CS-18 is one of 2 so far that use batteries. Most of them are just your typical prime and shoot, but this one uses, it's kind of disappointing, 4C batteries over here on the side. And, you know, I was hoping it was going to use double A's or they'd have some type of pack, but unfortunately it is 4C batteries. Now, you can trick it a little bit and put double A's in there, but, just use the C's. But I think this is actually a super prime candidate for a LiPo mod. This has ample enough room back here for a small battery LiPo or even a larger size LiPo. And I think that's the first thing that I'm going to do this blaster is LiPo mod it. Because you guys know me, I just don't want to use the C batteries and have just mass of those things just being chewed through. So let's take a look right at the box. Let's hop right in. So you can see the front of the box, I mean, it's actually a rather large box. When I saw this, I was like, oh, whoa, this looks pretty nice. Claims to shoot 90 feet, so we know what 90 feet kind of usually equals when it comes to FPS, right? One of the cool things they're doing with the Elite series, guys, is, I mean, you already know this. It is coming with... oh my gosh, you guys already know it, 36 darts, which is awesome. They did something right along this, you know, along this line. I hear a lot of people say, well, the Elite series is a no. And I think it's actually not that bad, especially with all the darts they give you. 36, you know, if you can restock your clip, your magazine, whatever you want to call it, if you can restock that twice, that's awesome. And then they give you just a few extras because you never know. You're going to lose some like me. I shoot some, I lose some. Oh, no, what's going on? So I think that's awesome. They've been including a lot of extra darts with their particular blasters. Now, on the back, again, they kind of follow that theme, the whole kind of like spaceship-type theme from the bottom glowing, kind of giving it that new, fresh, contemporary look that I think on the box, which I think a lot of their newer products needed. But again, on the box, nothing too crazy on the back here. You know, the Turbine CS, 4 different tactical rails that you can do. I don't know. I think that's kind of cool. You know, it's definitely something new. I've been noticing the tactical rail kind of theme is one of the biggest things about this, right, is they're giving you more attachment endpoints because there's a lot of attachments that people have they want to put on their blasters, but some just don't have the options for it. So let's hop right in. You could see aesthetically right out of the gate, good looking blaster, nice, tight, compact. Unfortunately, the stock is not removable. Unlike, the Commander that we just did? It was very similar to that where you can remove the front piece, the front attachment, as well as the rear stock. But of course, that was non-electronic. But this one, yeah, stock's built in. Could be worse. Then of course, they do have the front attachment up here, which is your classic, you know, attachment that you can use. So you can put on, you know, any of your older style Nerf attachments. We do have the one here from the Commander. You can throw this particular one on there real quick, like that. Now, I think that's a little overkill because that adds, what is this, another 4. So that'd be 7 endpoints. I mean, it looks cool. Don't get me wrong. I mean, I don't know. I think that looks cool. One of the things I did notice about these front kind of pieces is you see how it doesn't actually lock in there. It goes, but it doesn't lock, and it's very kind of flimsy. When I was kind of moving this from blaster to blaster, I noticed it was kind of flimsy, it kind of wobbled, and that actually kind of reciprocates what some of the other Nerf reviewers were saying about this particular blaster, and actually the attachments in general, is after you use them a couple times, they're kind of like a little flimsy. But let's talk about the tactical rails on the stock, right? It has 1, 2, 3, 4, so you technically got one on the top, kind of towards the back, where you can put, you know, I don't know, a grip up front, you know, whatever it is that you want to put on there. I like that. They put a lot of different tactical rails on here, so you can kind of customize it to whatever it is that you like. Now, the clip itself is going to be an 18-round clip. I don't know. To me, it kind of sticks out a little far, so I usually would like to go for the 25-round magazine. It doesn't stick out as far as you guys can kind of see, but it gives you a little more capacity, and it's kind of a little more tight. But again, it is all personal preference. I didn't have a problem with this magazine when shooting it. I do like they have the kind of little bumper guard or whatever you want to call it on the bottom there, which I think is cool. But I like the bigger drum mag here. Now, one of the things to note about when removing this magazine that I noticed is, you know, most of these kind of mag releases here, you can just push on the top, the bottom, the middle, and it would just release it. Mine, you really got to push on the top of that little button right there. You got to push on the top or it won't release. You could push all day on the bottom and it ain't going to release. So I don't know if it's just mine or that's just how they configured it, but I noticed that the first couple times that I was shooting this particular blaster. Now, the grip itself isn't too bad. It's very similar to the rest of them in the Elite series. Maybe a little bit kind of pinched in kind of this back area back here, where kind of it goes up at the angle, but it still feels good in the hands. And again, I have bigger adult hands, so it actually feels pretty good. So you're able to, you know, kind of shoot that absolutely no problem. The trigger pull, not too bad. Again, I feel like they're a little tad on the heavy side, but I do think this blaster is a prime candidate for a little bit of modification, especially a LiPo mod. I think that's probably going to be the very first thing that I'm going to do on this particular blaster. And I'm probably just going to bump it up to the 7.2 LiPo. I'm not going to go a 3S. So this will give you, you know, about 20% more performance and let you kind of speed up those motors a little more and probably give you a little more lifetime and over the longevity of your blaster, definitely save you on some of those particular C batteries. So let's take a look at the video here of me shooting it. Again, this is going to be a single shot blaster normally, but it's also full auto. So I just like shooting it singly because when you let the motor spin up, you get about 10 FPS more, but you still have the ability to just hold down the trigger and for it to go full auto. So you'll rip through all 18 Nerf darts there really, really quick. So it's just something to kind of think about. Let the motor spin up, you get a little more distance, shoots a little harder comparison to if you just let her rip, right? That's why I really like that 25-round drum magazine, because you're able to just load more in there. It's a little more compact, and you could just rip through all of those. So as you can see here, FPS, you guys know it. We were getting, you know, if we did the full auto, we were dropping to about 70. If we let it rev up for a second and then shot, we were getting about 80. And 80 is what I typically expect when I see somebody claim about 90 feet in distance overall. That's about how far you got to go with these normal shots, about how fast you have to shoot. So again, I gave you a couple examples there of just kind of shooting it singly, kind of doing the full auto. But again, it's completely up to you. I think this is a particularly cool blaster. The only thing I didn't like, again, is the C batteries. I'm just kind of waiting for them to come out with a different style little pack for the smaller blasters, right? If you guys remember on the Nerf Rival series, they had these battery packs that you could use, which were great and saved you a ton of money when it came to just your Nerf Rival arsenal. I'm hoping they're going to do something like that here, where they can just have a little smaller one that you can buy and save yourself on the blaster when it comes to buying those C batteries. But again, guys, overall, I think this is an awesome blaster. It looks good, feels good. I love the attention to detail on it. I like all the little kind of, I don't even know what you want to call those, venting holes, the etching, the little screws, the bolts, the little panels. I love all of that on there. I think it looks great. And I'm hoping that, you know, when some of you guys see this at your local Walmart, you might say, yeah, you know what? I could pick one of those up because it is going to run you, I think this one ran us almost $40, which is higher on the scale when it comes to these Elite blasters. But I still think it is kind of cool just for the sheer fact that, you know what, it's the second, electronic blaster in this series. I assume they're going to have more, and I kind of like it. 36 darts, you know, I don't like the C batteries, but I like how it looks, and I like how it shoots, I like how it feels. I don't know. Anyways, let me know what you guys think in the comments of this particular blaster, because I'm curious, too, to see if some of you guys were able to pick this thing up before the masses got it, and what you guys kind of think about it. Anyways, definitely subscribe, guys, if you haven't already. Thanks again, Fox fans.